Become AutoCAD expert step by step. Hello friends, I am your guide Amit Garg. You're watching my channel CAD by Amit. Friends, we have finished the important commands from the draw tab. From this lecture, I am starting very important commands from the modify tab. We have divided all the modification commands into three lectures. And in this lecture, I am going to cover the first six commands. The commands are as follows: erase, move, copy, mirror, offset, and rotate commands. And we are going to cover all the commands with relevant examples. Another very important information is, at the end of this lecture, friends, you will find one playlist icon coming up on the screen. So in case you want to see my previous lectures or you want to run all the lectures from the playlist, you can click on that to run all the lectures in the proper sequence. So let's get started with this lecture. Command number one, erase command. Shortcut is E. Erase command is used to erase selected objects. We have another important command which can be used with erase command, and that is oops command. Oops command is used to unerase objects from the previous erase command. Now friends, we all know what is the purpose of erase command. So we'll be working on erase command, and along with the erase command, I'll tell you about the selection methods, important selection methods in AutoCAD drawings. Because once you understand the proper selection methods in the drawing, you can select your objects efficiently and quickly. So let's start on model space. Friends, in this drawing, I have created few random objects. Like I've created few rectangles, few arcs, and few circles. I want to work with erase command. So I can type down E as the shortcut for the erase command. I can take the command from modify panel by clicking on this particular command. Otherwise, I can catch erase command from modify panel. I can get it from here. I click here to run the erase command. Now we get a select objects prompt here. Supposingly I want to erase all the objects from my drawing, then the best method for selecting all the objects from the drawing is to type down all in front of select objects command prompt. As I press enter, all the objects will get selected, and as I press another enter, all the objects will be erased because my command was erase command. Now to get these objects back, we have a oops command. So I can type down oops and press enter to get all the objects back. We again go for an erase command. Now this time I want to select specific objects to be erased. Now these selection methods can be used with any modification command, not only with erase command. Now here I want to erase only rectangles from the drawing. So I can click on these rectangle objects one by one. And as I click on the objects, these objects will get selected, and when I press enter, will get erased. I want to get them back, can type down oops. We get these objects back. We again go for a erase command. Now this time I again want to select rectangle objects. I'm clicking on the rectangle objects, but by mistake, suppose I selected another object, that is a circle object. Now how do we remove a selected object from the selection? For that, we simply press shift key on the keyboard and we click on the object that we want to remove from the selection, and the object gets removed. We press enter and the objects are erased. We type down oops to get the objects back. Another method of selection is we go for a command, then we make a window. Now this window, we start from the left hand side and then we drag our mouse towards right hand side. The color of this window is blue color, and this is what we call as a normal window. The feature of the normal window is all the objects which are coming completely within this window will get selected, and the objects which are on the boundary of the window, that means they are partially outside the window and partially inside, will not get selected. You can see when I click here, these two objects which were partially inside and partially outside, rectangle and the arc, are not selected. When I press enter, the command is executed and we can type down oops to get them back. Another method for selection is we give the command. Now this time I'm making a window from the right hand side. I click here and then I drag the mouse towards left hand side You can see the color of this window is green color. This is what we call as a crossing window. Now the feature of this window is all the objects which come inside the window and the objects which are coming partially inside the window, even if this window is touching a particular object, that will get selected. So when we are supposed to select maximum objects from the area, we normally work with a crossing window. As I press enter, the objects selected get erased and we can type down oops command to get them back. Another method of selection is to use a CP option here. A CP option stands for a crossing polygon. A crossing polygon will allow me to make a crossing, but this will be a polygon shapewise. I mean, in the window option, crossing window option, the shape was rectangular, but here the shape is polygonal and we can pick all the objects that we want to select. As we press enter, objects will get selected and objects will get erased. I can type down oops command to get them back. And I am telling you the last option for the selection, and that is your fence option. For the fence option, we can type down F, we press enter. In the fence option, we get a single line. And supposedly I want to select all the arc objects, so I can just cross all the arc objects with this single line, or we call this as a fence. And as I press enter, all the arcs are selected. I can press enter to erase the objects. I can type down oops to get them back. So that was a erase command, and we have worked on some selection options in AutoCAD. Command number two, move command. The shortcut is M. Move command is used to move the object from its current location. We have two main methods, A, displacement, B, reference. In this diagram, we have created one square object here, and the side of this square is 10 millimeters. Now this square, I want to move towards right hand side in the horizontal direction. And I want that the displacement from the center of this object to the center of the moved object should be 50 millimeters. So this is how we use a displacement method to move the object from its current location or the original location. The second option is with the reference. Now here we again have one square object having all the sides equal to 10 millimeters. I want to place the center of this square at the end point of this line. So here we already have one reference object and we have a reference location. So I'll select this object using the move command. I'll pick this object from the center of this square and I'll place it at the end point of the line. Here we'll have to use the object snap options, the relevant object snap options. So let's go to the model space and try out few examples. So we have come to the model space, and here I have created the same square here having each side equal to 10 millimeters, and I've connected its diagonally opposite vertex points using two lines. Now we go for a move command by typing down M here. This is a shortcut for the move command. Otherwise, we can pick the command from the modify tab by clicking on the move command here, or else we can take it from the modify panel by clicking on the move command here. Suppose I click here to pick the move command. I'll select the object that I want to move, press enter. Now software is asking for the base point. Now base point is the point through which I want to move the object. So in this case, I want to select the object from the center point of this square. So I'll select this point as the base point. We give the direction because I want to move it in the horizontal direction towards right hand side. So the best way is to keep ortho option on. And we just give the direction and type down 50 here. And the object is moved from its original location to the new location by 50 millimeters. Next option is reference option. I again type down M to start the move command. I select the object, press enter, pick it from the base point, move it and place it at the end point of the line. And here we are, the object is moved to the new location, that is the end point of the line. Command number three, the copy command. The shortcut is CP and CO. copy command is used to make a copy of selected objects by giving A, displacement, B, reference. For the example, here we created one square having each side equal to 10 millimeters. I want to make the copy of this object towards right hand side by 50 millimeters, upwards 50 millimeters, left hand side 50 millimeters and down 50 millimeters. And then I want to make other copies at 45 degrees from this object center to this object center. The reference is 45 degrees and the displacement is same 50 millimeters. Then towards in the second quadrant, and here this angle is 45, but here the angle will be 90 plus 45 degrees, that means 135 degrees. Similarly, if I want to copy this object into the third quadrant, the angle will be 180 plus 45 degrees, that means 225 degrees. And while copying it to the fourth quadrant, the angle should be 270 plus 45, that means 315 degrees. So this is how we make multiple copies of this object. So let's go to the model space and try this example. So I placed this drawing for the reference on the right hand side, and I have one square here with each side equal to 10 millimeters, and I want to create a similar diagram using the copy command. For the copy command, friends, we can go to the modify panel, modify tab, and we can take it from here. We can take the copy command from the modify panel, or we can simply type down CP as the shortcut. We type down CP, press enter, we select this object, press enter. I'll create four copies first of all in the orthographic directions, that means in the horizontal and vertical directions. So I'll simply switch on ortho option. For that we can click on this command or we can press F8 to switch it on. I pick this object's base point, give the direction and type down 50 because the displacements are 50. Then upwards 50, left hand side 50, then down 50. After this, since we are already working with the dynamic input option on, now I have to copy this object at the angles. So I give the distance first, which is 50, and for the angle we'll use the less than sign, and then we'll give the angle as 45, and the object is copied. Again 50, now this time the angle will be 90 plus 45, that means 135, and the object is copied into the second quadrant. Then again 50 is the displacement and the angle will be 180 plus 45, that means 225. This is copied in the third quadrant, and finally the 50 is the displacement and angle should be 315 degrees, and this is copied into the fourth quadrant. And another example is copying with the reference. We go for a copy command, we select the object, press enter, we pick it from the base point and we place it at the end point of the line, and the object is copied. Command number four, the mirror command. The shortcut is MI. Mirror command simply mirrors the objects and create a symmetry about a mirror line. Original object can be retained or deleted. For the example, I have created few objects here. We have created four objects, and here we have one line AB. I want to mirror all these objects about this mirror line. So objects will simply get mirrored on the right hand side, and the objects are placed in a symmetric way. That means this distance from here and this distance from here to here will be exactly equal. So these are the original objects and these are the mirrored objects. And while mirroring, we have the option of erasing the original objects. In that case, in case we say yes to erase the original objects, these objects from here will be erased and objects will be simply mirrored towards right hand side. So let's go to the model space and try out. So we have a geometry that we want to mirror. We have a mirror line AB about which we want to mirror the objects. We go for a mirror command by clicking on modify tab, and we can pick the mirror command from here. Otherwise, we can pick the mirror command from the modify panel by clicking on this command, or we can use its shortcut MI. So I click on this to run the mirror command. See, I'm selecting these four objects using a crossing window. Press enter. Now, asking for the first point of the mirror line, I pick this point. Second point of the mirror line, I pick this point. Now, software is asking, you want to erase the source objects, yes or no? Suppose I do not want to erase my original objects here, then I'll keep it on N. N means no. And as I press enter, the objects will get mirrored. Now let us mirror this again by using a horizontal line this time. That means I am going to mirror all of these objects about this horizontal line. So we go for a mirror command again by typing down MI. I am selecting all the objects by using a crossing window. I press enter. I pick first endpoint of the line. I pick second endpoint of the line. And this time I want to erase my original objects. So I'll say yes for erase option. And as I press enter, see the objects are mirrored about the horizontal mirror line. And the mirror line can be at certain angle also. Like in these two examples, in one case, the mirror line was vertical. In the second, the mirror line was horizontal. We can have a mirror line at certain angle also. You can try out that thing also. We have another very important option available in the mirror command, and that is how to mirror text. Now I'm taking two situations. Here I've written AutoCAD word here. And in the first case, when I mirrored this AutoCAD text, this is not mirrored. This is simply copied. And in the second case, this same word AutoCAD is mirrored about the mirror line AB. Now what is the difference? The difference is in the first case, I have to keep one variable mirror text value equal to 0 in case I do not want to mirror the text. Because in the drawings, sometimes we want to mirror the text and sometimes we do not want to mirror the text. We have both the situations or the options available in AutoCAD. And that is by using another variable mirror text. In case we keep mirror text value to 0, text is not mirrored. And in case we keep mirror text value to 1, the text is mirrored. So let's go to the model space and try out this example. We are into the model space. We have written the text AutoCAD 2 times. And here I do not want to mirror the text. That means I want to keep my text straight. So for that, I need to check mirror text command before we go for a mirror command. So I'll simply type down mirrtext, enter. And the value of this should be 0. So I set it to 0. I press enter, go for mirror command, enter. I'll select this text, enter. I'll catch this endpoint and this endpoint. So you can see, friends, that this text is not mirrored. Again, we go for a mirror text command and I keep its value to 1. We again go for a mirror command. We select this text, press enter. I catch this endpoint. I catch this endpoint. And in this case, the text is mirrored. So this is how we mirror text. Command number 5, offset command. Shortcut is O. Offset command is used to offset geometry at some distance, B, passing through a reference point. So we have two options in the offset command. In option number 1, we can offset the object by giving some distance. Like in these two diagrams, in the first diagram, I am offsetting the lines at the distance of 5 millimeters. And here I am offsetting a circle again at the distance of 5 millimeters. So this is what we call as offsetting the object at a distance. So let's check with the example. So here I have created one line having a length of 25 millimeters, created another circle. We go for an offset command by typing down O. Otherwise, we can take it from the modify tab by clicking on this command, or we can catch it from the modify panel. So I go for an offset command by typing down O. We want to keep the distance as 5 millimeters. I'll type down 5. I'll select the line and click on the right hand side to offset it at the distance of 5 millimeters. If you click on the right hand side, this will offset towards right hand side. If you click on the left hand side, this will offset the object towards left hand side. Then in offset option, we have another option available, and that option is like we go for the distance as 10 suppose, and I select the object. Then we have one multiple option here. So we type down M for the multiple option. And as I click on the side, one side of the object, we can get multiple objects coming up with each click. As I click on the screen, every time we click, we get one object at the same distance of 10 millimeters or whatever distance we had given. So this is how we can use the offset command multiple times, and that will take less time. And if you can try out the offset command on a circle as well, we go for an offset command, give the distance as 5, I select the circle, and as I click inside, the circle will get offset inside. In case I click outside, the circle will get offset outside. The next option in the offset command is a through point option. Here I have few parallel lines and I have one circle here. Suppose I want to offset this circle so that my new circles are passing through the end points of all the lines. In that case, I do not know what are the distances. So in this case, I should go for a through point option. And as I select circle and as I select the end points of the line, we get a circle which is passing through the end point of the lines. So this is how we can use the through point option. So friends, I've created one circle and I have like few parallel lines, and I want that each time I offset the circle should be passing through the end points of all the lines. So we go for the offset command by typing down O. In this case, I need not give the distance, rather I'll type down T for taking up a through point option. So I'll just type down T here, press enter. We select the circle and we give the through point as the end point of this line. We again select circle, give the through point. We again select the circle, give the through point. Or otherwise we can take up the multiple option, and in that case we would not be selecting the circles again and again. So you can see that we get multiple circles this time, and all the circles are passing through the end points of the lines. Command number 6, rotate, shortcut RO. Rotate command is used to rotate our object about a base point by a given angle. We have two ways of rotation in the two-dimensional drawings. One is we can rotate the object in the anti-clockwise direction. For rotating the object in the anti-clockwise direction, the rotation angle should be given with positive sign and the angle should be positive. And for rotating the object in the clockwise direction, the angle should be negative angle. Now here we have a rectangle. I want to rotate it by 30 degrees in the anti-clockwise direction first. We'll go for a rotate command by typing down RO, or we can take it from the modify tab or modify panel. We select the rectangle, press enter. We take the base point, because whichever point we take as a base point will remain fixed on its position. I take this corner of the rectangle as the base point and give the rotation angle as 30 degrees, and the rectangle is rotated. We again go for a rotate command, but this time I select the same rectangle, I pick the base point, and I go for a copy option this time. So for copy option, we have to type down C, press enter, and then I give angle as minus 30. So you can see that the same rectangle, the original rectangle, is not rotated from its position, rather we get a new copy of the same object which is rotated by an angle of minus 30 degrees. So this is how we can use a copy option within the rotate command. We have another very good option here, and here we are going to rotate the object taking the reference of this line. That means I want to rotate this rectangle so that the baseline of this rectangle is rotated at the same angle as the angle of this line. Now I do not know what is the angle of this line, and number two, I need not know the angle of the line actually. So what we can do is we can simply copy down this line, taking this end point of the line, and we'll place it on this corner of the rectangle that I am going to take as the reference point or as the base point. Now we go for a rotate command. I'll select rectangle object only, press enter, take this point where the end points of both the objects are common as the base point. We go for a reference option by typing down R, enter. I'll pick this point and the second point of this base side of the rectangle, and then we need to select the second point of the line only. As I pick the second point of the line, the rectangle is rotated by the same angle as the angle of the line. So it's a very, very handy tool or handy option in the rotate command that we call as rotation with the reference. So friends, we have covered all the six commands from the modify tab in this lecture, and now we are going to work on some example, and that's going to be a very interesting example. In this example, we are going to create this layout of a living room where the living room length is 5000 millimeters and the breadth is 3800 millimeters. And we have to place few objects here, and we already have created these objects on the right hand side, and these objects have been converted into the blocks. Now, how and why do we convert one object into a block? These things we'll see in the future lectures, because block is a very important concept in AutoCAD drawing making. Now let us check out what all objects we are going to place in the living room. We'll be placing one or two single doors. We'll be placing a LCD panel. We'll be placing a sofa, which is one seater. We'll be placing a center table there. We'll be placing a sofa, which is three seater. We'll be placing side tables. We'll be placing one TV unit and the window. So these all the objects we'll be placing in our living room layout by using the commands that we have just covered in this lecture. So let's get started. So friends, we are all set to start working on this drawing. First of all, I'll place this three-seater sofa here at the corner of the room. I'll simply use the copy command CP, select the sofa, catch it from the endpoint. I'll place it at the corner of the room here. We'll simply zoom into this area. Now I want to move this sofa with a distance of 800 millimeters towards right hand side and 150 millimeters upwards or in the vertical direction. So we'll go for a move command. I'll select the sofa, enter. I'll pick this corner of the sofa as the base point, and then I'll type down 800 in the X coordinate. I'll use comma and then 150 in the Y coordinate. As I press enter, see, sofa is moved from its current location to the right location. Next is, I'm going to move this single seater sofa and I'm going to place it somewhere here. Go for a copy command, select this sofa, enter, pick it from the base point and move it and place it here, because first of all, I'm going to change its rotation or orientation. So we go for a rotate command here, press enter. I select this sofa, press enter. I pick its one of the base points, and for rotating the object by 90 degrees, it's always good to switch on ortho and then rotate it easily. Then I use the move command. I select this sofa, press enter. I take this as the reference point, and then I take this as the reference point here. And as I move it, see, I'm getting one inference line here. And friends, this is very important concept. Now this inference line is coming up because here on the status toolbar, I have switched on object snaps and plus object tracking. So this inference line is coming up because of object tracking, and we could catch the point on the sofa because of object snap. So both the options should be on. So as I take this point and I move it along this inference line, and as I come to the wall, we get this intersection point coming up. That means I have picked the point right in the horizontal alignment of that point on the three-seater sofa, and I simply confirm here by clicking. So my single-seater sofa is placed. But now I want to move this sofa in the horizontal direction by 150 millimeters, in the vertical directions by 150 millimeters. So we go for a move command, select this one, enter. We pick this point as the base point. I type down 150 in the X coordinate, comma 150 in the Y coordinate, enter. And the sofa is placed at the right position. I want to place another single seater sofa on the other side, or the right hand side of the three seater sofa. We'll go for a mirror command. I'll select this sofa, enter. I want to mirror it about this midpoint of the three seater sofa. I click here, and we switch on ortho option by pressing F8, because mirror line should be straight, and I pick the second point here and I say no for the erase source object. The single seater sofa is placed on the other side of the three seater sofa. Next is I am going to place this side table. So I'll copy it first of all. I pick it from here. I pick it from the corner of the table and I place it at the corner of the room. And then we have to simply move it. So go for a move command, select it, press enter. We pick this point as the base point, 150 in the x coordinate, comma 150 in the y coordinate. And the side table is also moved to the right position. Now we want another side table to be placed on the other side of the three-seater sofa. We'll go for a mirror command, select the side table, we pick its midpoint and we move it because ortho is on, so we get a straight line, vertical line, and the side sofa, side table is mirrored on the other side of the sofa. Now next, I'm going to place the LCD panel at the right position. So we go for a copy command again. We select this one, press enter. We pick it from the midpoint of the back edge of the LCD panel. Now this one, I want to place right in the alignment of this midpoint actually. And see, we picked the midpoint on the three-seater sofa. And now we can use this object tracking thing so that the midpoint of the LCD panel is right in the alignment of the midpoint of the three-seater sofa. And as we come to the wall, we can see the intersection symbol is coming up and we can click there and my LCD panel is placed at the right location. The next is to place the TV unit. So we copy it first of all. We pick it from the midpoint of the backside edge. I will place it here first of all because we want to change its alignment. We go for a rotate command, select it, press enter, we pick it from the midpoint, we switch on the ortho option by pressing F9 and we simply rotate it, and then we can use the move command, select it, we catch it from the midpoint of the backside edge and we place it at the midpoint of the back edge of the LCD panel, and the TV unit is also placed. The next is the single door. I'll simply copy the single door. I'll pick it from the base point and we place it somewhere here because first of all, we have to change its orientation. So we go for a rotate command. I'll select it, press enter. We'll pick it as the base point and we rotate it after switching on the ortho option. We'll simply rotate it and we rotate it by 90 degrees and we place it here. Then we need to mirror it also because right now this door is getting open in the outside direction. Rather, I want to make it open in the inside direction. I'll go for a mirror command. I'll select it, press enter. We catch the base point and we simply mirror it. And then we can even erase this original object. And then we can move this by taking this point as the base point and we place it simply on the corner of the wall. Now we want to place another single door. We again copy it, we pick it from here. I'll place it somewhere on the drawing and then we can realign this by using the rotate command only. We go for a rotate command. I pick it using this point as the base point and we rotate it by switching on ortho and we rotate it in the right direction and then we simply move it. We pick it from this point and we place it at the end point of the wall and the single door is placed at the right position. And finally, we have to place this window now. And this window I want to place at the middle of this right hand side wall. So we'll go for a copy command again. We'll select the window, enter. Now I want to take this end point as the reference. And as I move cursor down, we start getting the inference line because of object tracking. And I catch its midpoint because of object snap and we get the intersection point of these two and see I have picked this window from the right base point and I can place it right at the midpoint of this wall. I click here and the window is at the right position. So this is how, using all the modification commands that we have covered in this lecture, we could make this living room layout. And now finally I can use a dynamic text to write down its annotation here. I want rotation as 0, and then I typing down living room and enter and enter. And here we are, the layout is complete, and you can simply place it at the right position. So this is how we could complete this living room layout using all the modification commands that we learned in today's lecture. So friends, I hope you enjoyed this lecture thoroughly. If you like this lecture, please press like button, share it with your friends. Please do subscribe my channel and do not forget to press bell icon. Thank you so much. See you in the next lecture soon. Take care.